What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. The next pattern we are going to cover is a famous one, and was mentioned several times during our previous videos. This pattern goes by the Builder pattern. The Builder is a creational design pattern that lets you create complex objects on a step-by-step basis. It allows you to produce different types and representations of an object using the same construction process. But what does that mean? Let us imagine a car class. To create a simple car, we need the brand, the model, the color, the number of doors perhaps, the car screen specifications, the weight and the height of the car. We may also need to generate a unique identifier for this car, and many other details. The initialization of the many fields of this object is usually buried inside a monstrous constructor with lots of parameters, or even worse, it could be scattered all over the client code. So to create an instance of the car class you see, we may use a constructor similar to the one in front of you, or another similar to this one. The second use highlights another issue with such constructors, and it is that sometimes we may not require filling or passing to this constructor all the fields of our class. Like even if the class contains 8 fields, we may require for this specific object to use only 5 of them, which makes the constructor calls ugly most of the time we use it. Another option would be to create several overloaded constructors and each time use the one we need. However, if you do that, you may end up with lots and lots of unnecessary constructors in your code. Here is when the Builder pattern comes in. This pattern suggests that we extract the object construction or creation code out of its own class and move it to separate objects called builders. So, inside this builder, we will have the same fields we have inside our car class. However, each field will have a reserved setter method, usually written without a setter prefix. And in addition to these methods, we will have a build method, which returns an instance of the object this builder is supposed to create. This build method will make use of a gigantic constructor defined at the level of the car class. We can't entirely get rid of it, however, this constructor will not be public, or shouldn't, at least in my opinion. And we do not have to worry whether we will be passing null values to this constructor or not, as the only call or use of this constructor will be placed inside the build method defined in our builder. Why did I just say that this constructor will not be public though? Because if the builder is outside the class we need to instantiate, its access should be package private. And if the builder is an inner class, also referred to as an inner builder, then its access should be private. By doing this, we restricted the access to this constructor to any other part of our application. So if anyone tries to create an instance of our object, he or she will be forced to instantiate it using the builder class and not the gigantic constructor. Now, if a user wants to create an instance of this class, all he has to do is create a builder and provide it with the various object parts he wants to create this instance from. After doing that, he just needs to call the build method, and this one will return to him the appropriate object based on the parameters he provided. Okay, what we just implemented is the most basic form a builder can take, but there is way more behind the builder pattern than what we just saw. Imagine we created several instances of the car class we have using the builder, and after doing this, we realize that the objects we are initializing in different parts of our application share certain similarities. Like here, all Bugatti cars created share the same attributes, or most of them at least. Same applies to Lamborghini cars and every car brand if we take its corresponding object separately. You see, that is the construction code I was referring to at the beginning of the video. And the builder pattern suggests that this code, the repeated series of calls and steps the builder is using, should be extracted to a separate class we call Director. The Director class defines the order in which we should call the construction steps so that we can create and reuse specific configurations of the products we are building. Having a Director class in a program is not strictly necessary. You can always call the building steps in a specific order directly from the client code as we previously did. However, the Director class might be a good place to put various construction routines so that they can be reused across several parts of your application. Additionally, the Director class completely hides the details of the product construction from the client code. So, if we want to create a Bugatti now, all we have to do is associate a builder with the Director, launch the construction using the Director, and get the result from the builder. In code, this is done as you see in front of you. Additionally, the nice thing about directors is their flexibility in dealing with various builder implementations. What do I mean by that? Suppose we encountered the need to create a schema object for this car. You see, the schema of the car will almost have the same fields of the car itself, because we need the same information and attributes we had inside the car to create its corresponding schema object, right? The schema and the car are not the same thing, hence we cannot use inheritance here to ease the creation process. Therefore, the car schema class will be an entity on its own, having its own builder. However, what we can reuse is the construction code stored inside the director class, as it makes sense to reuse this existing construction process for both real cars and their respective schemas. To be able to pass two different builders to the same director methods, what we have to do is create a common builder interface and make them implemented. The builder interface will declare our car construction steps that are common to all types of builders, in our case the car builder and the car schema builder. Our director will now accept this interface as a parameter, allowing us to use the same step-by-step construction process on both the objects we created. Now, before ending the video, I want you to take a look at the structure or class diagram of the builder design pattern. The builder interface and the director class are similar to the ones we created in our application, whereas concrete builders provide the different implementations of the construction steps. In our code, they were represented using the car builder and car schema builder classes. These builders will produce the different product classes, which in our code were represented using the car and car schema classes. Okay, as a recap, the intent of the builder design pattern is to create the construction of a complex object from its representation. To make use of the builder pattern, you have to create a builder class which contains the same fields of the objects you need created. Inside this class, you will have several methods that accept the parts or fields of the object you want to instantiate separately, in addition to another method responsible for the actual creation process of your object. Now, if the same creation code is used to create several objects in your application, then think about creating a director class. Directors encapsulate various ways to construct a product using the same builder object. If you are making use of a director class, the client code must create both the builder and the director objects and must pass the builder object created to the director. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.